Hey brothers and sisters. Hey brothers, this is my third video tonight. I already made a video about the Laodicean church, but I want to add on to it. Maybe I can merge these videos. But anyway, as I was just thinking about it, and someone had given me a dream they'd had, a sister from Scotland, I just thought about it, because I'd already made this video and already talked about it, the thousand shades of gray, a thousand shades of gray of Satan, like the book 50 Shades of Gray that's so popular with all the wicked people in the States. The Lord told me to make a video, and he gave me the title from the very beginning, and then he just gives me bits and pieces at a time for that video. And it's, I guess, a magnum opus video that the Lord wants me to make before the rapture, and it's called The Indictment of the Laodicean Church. Now, for those of you who do not know, the last church mentioned in the book of Revelation, in the Bible, Revelation chapter 3, is the Laodicean church, the lukewarm church. Now, the lukewarm church, what is lukewarm? Okay, in real life, that city had water that was brought to it on an aqueduct. The Romans used these aqueducts. The water came from a hot spring. So by the time it got to Laodicea, it was lukewarm. So that was a literal lukewarm water in that town. But Jesus wasn't talking about the water. He said, because you're lukewarm, you're neither hot nor cold. I wish you were either hot or cold, but since you're not, you're lukewarm, I'll spew you out of my mouth. So the end times church is a Laodicea lukewarm church. So what is lukewarm? That's what I'm trying to ask you. It's like this. Black representing evil, right? In the Bible, we see black darkness as Satan, evil, sin, right? Lack of the presence of God. We see light and, you know, white, like the white robes and all that, as a righteousness of God, the righteousness of Christ, the light of God. Okay, so when you mix this black and white together, what do you get? You get gray. You get shades of gray. And what is lukewarm? What is lukewarm? You take hot water and you mix it with cold water and you get warm water. Lukewarm water is the same as gray color. Lukewarm is gray. It's neither hot nor cold. It's neither black nor white. It's in between. And that is the indictment of the Laodicean church. Now, as I mentioned in the other video, since I didn't load it, I mentioned in some videos I loaded, I'll just say it again. The Council of Nicaea, the church sold out. They sold out on the original Pentecostal church, as they say in the writings of this, is it St. Augustine of Hippo? He wrote in his writings that the Holy Spirit came on him to speak in tongues, and he rejected it in his personal writings. He did not want to receive the Holy Spirit. He was intellectual. And he was a big contributing factor bringing in this Nicene Council. So this is what I'm trying to say. I'm not talking about Roman Catholicism. Really, you can look there in these different churches, in the different church ages, and you can see all the different levels of the church falling away and all that stuff. Okay, the Laodicean church, the end times church, is really all those past church ages and what's still going on today. The Catholic Church has been through all the church ages, except for the first or two church ages until the Council of Nicaea, until 300 and something after, what's his name? The Caesar there converted, supposedly in this sign conquer, allegedly converted to Christianity, Constantine and his mother, Helen. Anyway, so this is what happened. Not even talking about that. People want to keep talking about the Roman Catholicism, but that's not the point, because you already know about that. You know, and what's so wacky is that the millions of people, like the Waldensians and all that, millions of people were killed over the centuries for not bowing the knee to the Pope and bowing the knee to the doctrine, all the compromise, all the shades of gray of the Roman Catholic Church. The shades of gray. There's a little bit of white in there. There's a little bit of hot water or cold water. I don't know. Whichever one is you want to say, I guess the cold water is good. Or the hot water. I don't know. Whatever. This shades of gray. A thousand shades of gray. And then the Protestants and all them came along, and people died for it. And then you had a breakthrough of translating the Bible into the vernacular of the people, like Martin Luther into German. And then, Wycliffe or whatever, and all those guys there in England who translated it into English and then ended up being the King James, like the movie A Lamp in the Dark and A Tares Among Wheat. I ask you to watch those videos, documentaries. You can watch them for free on YouTube by Chris Pinto. Excellent, about the history of the Word of God. What's going on? But the thing is that people love to keep talking about the Catholic Church. Okay, and it's all, everybody knows, you know, if you're not a Catholic, and you know, it's a general knowledge that they have got all this traditions that's been added on for all these years, for the last 15, 16, 1700 years, since 325 AD or whatever it is, the Council of Nicaea. All this stuff's been added and added and added slowly over the years to have all these thousand shades of gray. We all know that. But the Laodicean church is all of these Protestant denominations now that even deny the Lord that bought them. They deny the virgin birth. People keep talking about the Catholics worshiping the Virgin Mary. What about the Protestants who deny the virgin birth, that Mary wasn't a virgin, and that Jesus wasn't born of a virgin? How about that? That's much worse. That's much more worse. They're even denying that Jesus was born of a virgin. They're denying the deity of Christ, and they're denying that the Word of God comes from God. Am I defending Catholicism? No. I'm saying that the Catholic Church says that the Bible and their tradition, they have their traditions. Now, Protestant movement came what they call sola scriptorium, which is in Scripture alone. That's what all, you know, that's another thing. Catholics love to call everybody that's not a Catholic a Protestant. That's not true, because all the new evangelicals and the Pentecostal churches and all that came out of the Protestant, but we're not in protest against the Catholic Church. That's the Protestant movement. You're talking about your Presbyterians, your Lutherans, and all those, what they try to call themselves, mainline Protestant denominations, when in reality, they're the smallest denominations, much smaller, you know, than your evangelical denominations, like Southern Baptist is the biggest denomination in the United States. Okay, anyway, so you've got all these, let me see. Okay, I'm trying to lay this out right for you. So anyway, the problem with this Laodicean church is these churches that once walked in just the just shall live by faith, like Martin Luther, now they're not even part, anywhere remotely part of the body of Christ. They've denied the name of the Lord. They're denying the deity of Christ, the virgin birth of Christ. All these denominations are in total denial as the Word of God being the Word of God. Go read their websites. Go read what they say. The Bible is not the Word of God. The Bible contains the Word of God. I know Southern Baptist preachers who have told me in private, after they got their master's degree and they became high theologians, what they learned in school was is the Bible is not the Word of God, but it contains the Word of God. There's a difference. They're saying part of the Bible is true, the parts that they pick and choose, like Thomas Jefferson did, and the other parts that they don't like, was written by man and not inspired by God. That's exactly what they mean. That's the Laodicean church. Shades of gray, mixing light with dark, cold and hot, mixing all these things together. Now, I should do an indictment of each different section. The Protestants, I'm talking about them right now. Of course, I've made lots of videos talking about Roman Catholicism. We know that. We know that they're relying on their traditions and exalting the Pope above the Scripture. They're saying their traditions override the Scripture, which it does not. If the they're saying if the Pope is infallible when he's sitting on the chair, and if he says A, then it's A, and he's infallible. That overrides the Scripture. In other words, it can rewrite it. No. We're not talking about that right now. That's so far out of the ballpark, we already know that. I'm talking about those who claim to be part of Christianity. I haven't even started talking about the Pentecostals. You read that text, and what do you think of when you read it, when it says Jesus said you think you're rich, but you're not. You're poor, blind, and naked. That's the Pentecostal movement. What do the Pentecostals say? Oh, prosperity gospel and all that? We think you're rich, but you're not. We can see. We have prophetic gifts and all the gifts of the Spirit. We can see, but Jesus said, no, you think you can see, but not. You're poor, blind, and naked. You're naked. You don't have any righteousness. You're living in sin. You're not walking in the righteousness of God. That's what's happened to most of the Pentecostal movement. That's them in there. Of course, I haven't even got to your in between your Baptists and all that. Of course, they deny the Holy Spirit. They believe in once saved, always saved. People can live in sin. They don't even believe in holiness at all. Pentecostals have taught holiness, but they don't live it. Majority of people. That's the Laodicean church. We have 50 shades of gray, 1,000 shades of gray in the church. It's just so much, brothers and sisters. I'm going to see if I can cover this, because I made another video and I think I'm going to redo it in this video. Maybe I won't. I'm going to go review those videos and load these. This is, I'm just going to cut this one off now where I'm at right now. The indictment of the Laodicean church, part one. But you're neither hot nor cold. You think you're rich, but you're not. You're poor, blind, and naked. And you need to repent. You need to turn back to the Lord. You need to get all the gray. You need to wash that gray right out of your spirit. You need to wash that gray right out of your heart. Like the old commercial says, you need to Get rid of that gray hair and the gray areas in your heart and your walk with the Lord. And you need to come clean with the Lord. Repent, therefore. You need to buy gold tried in the fire from the Lord. Get eye salve from the Lord so you can see. And get a robe of righteousness from the Lord, a white robe. That's the Laodicean church. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent. Come back to your first love. Stop what you're doing. Jesus is knocking at the door of your church. And that's where two or more gathered in my name. He's knocking at the door. People say, oh, he's knocking at the door of your heart. No, it says he's knocking at the door of the church. Anyone in the church or the Laodicean church, that's us, and we'll let him in. We will sup with him and he will sup with us. We're going to be eating supper with the Lord at the marriage supper of the Lamb. When we open the door to the Lord, let the Lord take over your life, every area. That's the problem. And you don't know how many people message me every day and say, well, Brother Patrick, I got this part of my life. I was having a hard time surrendering about looking at pornography. I'm a hard time surrendering about pleasuring myself. That's one of the biggest ones that people message me about. I'm having a hard time surrendering that. I'm having a hard time. As Paul said, get married or repent of it or get married today. If you can't control yourself, it's better to be married than to burn, Paul said. Get married or stop it. Do something. If you can't control yourself, get married, as Paul said. In your incontinence, in your lack of self-control, get married. So what you need to do is just that simple, or repent. If you can't control yourself, get married. I mean, what part of that don't people understand? Now that I'm on that topic, I don't know why it came up. It must be for somebody. There's people that, and I mentioned this before, I bet I get 10 people a day who message me with that same problem. I'm looking at internet porn, and I can't stop pleasuring myself. Well, if you're so desperate to pleasure yourself, why do you need to look at porn? I mean, where's the porn connection coming in? You know, if it's just, you know, you have this lack of self-control, then why do you need to watch porn if you're just, you know, obviously the porn is fueling it. It's not on its own. So what's up? Let's get let me take that back. It's not a gray area. Okay. This is a crystal clear area. This is a crystal clear area. This is not even a gray area of the things that I'm really talking about. The Lord had me bring it up. There you go. It's an example of how the Lord will speak through us as we're speaking his word. Brothers and sisters, today is the day of salvation. Today is the day of righteousness. Today is the day of holiness. Today is the day of repentance. Get right with God right now. I'm going to go review that other video. I have a lot of cool stuff that the Lord was showing me that I made on the other video. See if I'm going to upload it too. God bless you guys. Pray for the orphanage, all the new orphans. I ask you to pray for that. I ask you to pray for my voyage to the States, myself and my wife. Pray for our to accomplish God's missions there. That this group is going to come build an orphanage. By the grace of God, I'll be meeting them with them while I'm in the States to finalize approval to come here and build an orphanage here in the Philippines. I ask for your prayers for that because I believe in, the Lord spoke to me, and I believe in my faith that we'll have 3 orphanages operating in this year of our Lord 2014. God bless you guys. Go in peace. Amen. May the Lord be with you today.